Alright, hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Threads of Fate. I am SIMSteven, also known as Master Federal, and we're doing Min Story, of course. Last time we were told to head off to the Gamul Forest, and we'll get the earrings for Primadol. So, we gotta go through the gate, right? Oh, Mint, where are you off to now? Yeah, it's Mira, Klaus's wife, in case you forgot. We haven't really seen much of her since, the Corona Forest, and well, now we're going to the Gamul Forest. So, Min saying, I'm going to the Gamul Forest. Spellcaster Jinima's Adelaide is supposed to be there. How are you going to get there? It takes at least a week by foot. What? A week? If you take a canoe upstream, it takes 3 days. Dang, what does it have to be so far? Don't be discouraged. I have a great idea. Really? It's a man named Rod who's camping in the grass fields outside of town. He has a boat. He's boasting that his baby is the best machine in the world. Why don't you go talk to him? Fastest machine? Sounds bogus, but it looks like I have no other choice. Alright, so yeah, this is kind of why I was saying at the end of the last episode that you should probably try and fight Rod with the Silver Breeze before, you know, going to Mills Allier's, because at this point in time in the game, we actually need to, you know, do some story-related stuff with the Rod, and he will no longer fight us with the Silver Breeze. So if you want the money and the gold coin from that, well, you can't get that now. However, speaking of stuff like items and gold coins and stuff, still can't do anything with this legendary sword. You can sell everything else here if you want to. You might want to keep the coins for continues, of course, but other than that, I want to talk about that one panel I've kind of avoided talking about it so far and avoid showing entirely. This is basically the mount. These are all called monster coins, but basically they're just bounties. Every time you kill a monster, it adds to your tally of each of the monsters. And because I've actually killed everything here so far, with the exception of the skeleton and the puppet, I feel I could at least show this first page. I can actually scroll down a little ways, but there are monsters and, in fact, bosses, which we have not seen. So that's why I'm not going to go scroll down any farther. Instead, I'm just going to show you this. It tells you the names of everything you've fought so far, and you can actually go to places like Tonio's shop and sell these things. Yeah, I know I've kind of explained this before, but I just kind of do this for a little bit of demonstration. You can see, with all the monster coins I've had from multiple playthroughs, mind you, I could get 23,000 gold. So yeah, that's the alternative way to get money when you run out of things to sell, like stones, and if you want to sell your coins. So yeah, that's how you will want to grind money in case you want to get the upgrade to Hobbs' shop for like the 5,000 gold upgrades and all that. So yeah, just kind of want to go over that and just want to point out the fact that I'm not going to show the whole page of monsters and such, but yeah, there are bosses and stuff, and Blood and Smokey have their own coins, which is why you want to kill them at least once in each story. You know, just so you can have it to fill in the list of monster coins and all that. Anywho, Rod's here sleeping. We try to wake him up. He just rolls over. Mint, long time no see. What brings you here? Hi, Rod. I came here because I want to ask you for a favor. Oh, boy. All right. What's on your mind? That's it? You just want to get to the Gamul Forest? Well, you came to the right place. I'm the man who can get you there. My ACV is the best ride around. And Johnny is camera bombing once again. But everything has a price. You want my help? You gotta pay up front. You know what I want, don't ya? No, I don't. Think. Oh, yeah. Alright, let's fight. Right on. That's what I'm talking about. Tell you what, just as once, I'll fight you free of charge. You'd better let me borrow your boat when I win. Well, yeah, when I win, not if I win, when I win. Hey, my baby's in a boat. If not, then what is it? Gotta beat me to find out. Come on. I think win or lose, you'll be able to get to the Gamul Forest, regardless of, you know, the outcome of this fight. Thankfully, it's free, so you have to do this for story purposes. You don't have to pay him 100 gold, but Yeah, I don't even know if... I think if you lose, you might have to go run an errand for him or something like that. But I think you should probably just save and try to win just in case. You won't last a minute against my... What the heck? And you might have seen this in a... caught a glimpse of this earlier, but... He's got a new weapon! Okay, Mint, bring it on! What is that thing? My latest creation. Golden Gale, here I come! And they're basically two scythes. Later on, when we get back from the Gamble Forest, you can actually fight Rod over and over again and get more money and get another gold coin from him. Unless you beat him 5 times, of course. But I'm just kind of showing off his moves here. He has a spinning jump attack. He tries to, you know, stab us or something like that. And tries to use both. And, oh, something I really haven't mentioned before is I think if you hit Rod a lot, Johnny will actually come in and try to bite you as well, but he only does like 1 damage. Okay, there's another one of his moves. He'll kind of do this sidestep and try to swing 5 times, something like that. There's one move I'm hoping to show, but I don't know if he'll use it until he's at like half his health or at least or something like that. I'm just going to try to run away from him, see if he'll actually use it. But it looks like he's not really using it at all. Yeah, I'm taking 1 damage at a time because I've got 999 defense. But yeah, me and my overpoweredness. Gonna use it at all. Probably not. Oh well, I guess we won't get to show it. There's one other move which I think he'll use once he's low on health. Basically, he'll stick his scythes into the ground and they'll chase you around like sharks. Yeah, and he can still use the hilt of his, that silver part of his weapon, you know, to hit you as well. So you gotta watch out for multiple targets all at once. And they'll come back to him after a few seconds, but yeah, you probably just want to jump around a lot. And of course, same usual techniques when you fight Rod, is you want to try and jump kick and get in, get out kind of strategy. Anyways, I win! Damn, you're good. Damn right I am. And by the way, E for everyone, everybody. That was a good fight. I guess I gotta give you that ride. I'll take you to Gamul Forest. Really? Yeah. Yeah, right out the place so hard. Never goes back on his word. Why don't you go kill some time when I get it ready? Okay, so next objective is we gotta go back to Klaus's place. And I think we gotta talk to Klaus, and he says... You know, hey, Rod will take you to the Gamble Forest. That's great. Are you ready to go? And I think that's all we really got to do. But yeah. In fact, we'll actually see it here. I'll do that. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, so no. I think I might have been wrong. I think all we got to do is exit out and then go back in. If not, I'll just wander around town until I figure out what I'm supposed to do. Because I don't always remember, but you can usually figure it out. If you just go down the alleyways and stuff. So, is it ready? Is it all I had to do was come out into town and go back in? I don't remember. Oh, yeah, here it is. Yeah, that's all it was, is I just had to go back in town and, you know, cut away with the screen. They didn't actually pull it out on screen or anything like that from the cave, which, you know, in the back left, that's where it's been hiding all this time. Took you so long. My baby's ready to go. So this is your boat, huh? It's not a boat! Don't ever call me my baby a boat. You got that? Geez, Rod. Sensitive much? Boat can't even compare to my baby. She's the love of my life. Her name? Pulsar. Inferno. Typhoon. Omega! Oh, by the way, look at how red this thing is. Remember when we first came to Corona and our big red thing, according to Bloodspooky, had crashed into the boat? What do you think crashed into the boat? I'll give you 2 guesses as to what that was. Like I said, she's the greatest friend in the world. Nothing can top this baby's speed. What was that again? Pulsar Inferno forget it. Pinto, there we go. What do you say, Pinto? It's not a bean! Hey, don't give my baby a stinky nickname, alright? It's a Pulsar Infernal Typhoon Omega. What a long, stupid name. Hey, I can care less about the name. It doesn't matter. It matters.
Look at her. She's perfect. The name's gotta be perfect too. But my baby's ready to take off anytime. You ready to go to Gamul Forest or what?
Alright, let's go.
I'm ready to go. Mint. Here's your lunch. Wow, you look yummy. Rod, your portion is in there too, okay? Thank you, madam. I'll savor every bite with all my heart. You silly. Good luck, Mint. Hey, what is that noise?
It's a sorcerer's driver, some kind of ancient magic device. There are 5 cannon orbs that juice up the pit driver to thrust my baby. See a sound in the world. Let's see, cannon orbs at max power, sorcerer's driver is all juiced up. Alright, you ready?
Yeah, go Pinto, go! I told you to stop calling it that. Pulsar, Inferno, Typhoon, Omega! Have a safe trip.
And we're off. Again. And sweet ride, let me drive it sometime.
So what do you think? She's got mad speed, huh?
Mint's quiet.
Just as advertised, the sweetest ride in the world. Hey, what's up? Why are you all quiet? This baby too fast for you? Hey, this meatball is pretty good. What? You're eating without me? What am I, your chauffeur? Your chauffeur? Stop whining. You're ruining the moon. The scenery's beautiful. The food's great. It's perfect. Just keep piling your baby. I swear, you better leave some for me. Oh, that was good. What should I try next? Let's see. Yeah, pumpkins. Rod, you can have my pumpkins and I'll take your meatballs, okay? I'll kill you if you do.
As you might guess, Rod loves his food, I suppose. Anyways, I think we're here. Pretty soon, I suppose. Alright. And he's just chilling after that awesome lunch.
That lunch was great. I've had a lot of lunches before, but that one lunch was the best. Yeah, it sure was. Alright, I'm all energized, ready to go. Rod, don't you get any funny ideas. You'd better be here when I come back with the earrings. Alright. I'm gonna take a nap here. So for a while, so relax. Oh, I'm so sleepy after that awesome lunch. Sweet dreams. I'll be back soon.
Alright, and we're here. And I think I heard just something outside just a minute. So let me pause the game just a sec here after we, get through this little scene here. And I'll cut things off and restart my recording here. So...
What? What happened to the alligator? I wonder if the earrings are still here. I guess I have no choice but to look. Dang, this sucks.
Alright, I'll be right back. 1 second for you, about 2 minutes for me. Alright, and I'm back. The alligator that we were supposed to investigate here, which had the earrings, has been completely destroyed. It's pretty much leveled except for the flooring and the tiles that were, underneath the building. And check the pot here, you get your MP refilled, which is pretty good. Sorry, I had to check something really quick. I actually was changing my looking at my magic because I think I remember I needed some magic, particular magic for the next upcoming fight in order to hit the next boss fight. Because once we check this journal, we actually will be heading into a boss fight. What's this? Maybe it's Ginnima's diary. Let's see. I hid the earrings in a safe place. Jackpot. Okay, baby. Where'd you hide them? I hid the earrings inside the guardian's body. This way, knowing no one can take my earrings. My guardian is in Spall. Why am I so smart? Dang, so where's the guardian? No, my guardian is wrecked. My alligator escaped. My alligator has been completely destroyed. My earrings are gone. My research is finished. What was I thinking, hiding the earrings inside a guardian? I'm such a fool. Dang, what an idiot. And head out into the center. Once again, or check the windmill back here. And... Oh yeah, this is what I was thinking about. I actually need something to run this windmill, but I don't have it just yet. So yeah, whenever I change my magic, I'm actually going to have to cut that out because, well, there's still some spoilery stuff when I open up my magic ring or the magic circle that I will whenever I need to change magic. So yeah, I'm not going to show what that looks like. Well, till very end of the game, actually, because it's that spoilery of a spoiler if I were to open up my magic ring. Anyways, check the windmill there, and she's like, what am I supposed to do now? I don't know where this guardian went. Who knows how long ago that was, but fireball comes out of nowhere.
Ha! Stay down! Dang, that stupid ha has to be Belle. Who are you calling stupid? You!
Expletive. Expletive is actually a bleeped out word. You know, like if you're watching TV and someone said something naughty and the censors went beep whenever they say something. That's what an expletive is. So, probably called her a B-I-T-C-H there. Always taking cheap shots. You should talk. You're the queen of foul plays, not to mention dirty mouths.
That's it. You are so dead.
So they actually did censor some words in this game. So I couldn't say E for everyone. But anyways,
Yeah, whatever. You're going to eat those words very soon. I have a special surprise for you. Hexagon!
So, yeah, this is how Belle got all the way out here when it takes a week to get here normally on foot. She also has a machine like, you know, like rods, even though it's different, I suppose.
What is that ugly thing? This is my ultimate weapon I found in the Coral Sea Ruins. Good luck, it has no weaknesses.
Coral Sea Ruins is actually not a place we can go to. It's just something that's been talked about. But I should actually at least point it out that that's the location of this world, which, you know, if they ever make a sequel, we should at least see something about that place. But, you know, it's not something we can actually go to here.
Anyways, what are you talking about? It's got you on it. You're its major weakness.
Zing!
What? You won't be able to lay a finger on me. Whatever, I'm going to beat you silly and knock you off that thing.
I think I actually need magic to knock her off, so forgive me if there's a cut in this fight, because I don't know if I have the right one equipped. Anyways,
ha! In your dreams. Hexagon is invincible!
Basically, what you want to do, avoid doing at least, is you do not want to stand in front of that thing when it's moving. Otherwise, you kind of saw that it kind of tried to grab me with both of its arms. What it'll do if that happens, let me just show you that. It'll grab you, and then it'll spin around. A really freaking long animation, and even if you're not like overpowered like me, it still does decent amount of damage. But let's see here. I think in order to beat her, we need to get on one of these platforms and use magic to hit her off. No, I couldn't jump kick her. Yeah, you actually need to have magic in order to hit her, and it has to be decently long range as well. Normally what I would do is use a spell that I'm not supposed to have at this point in the game. Unfortunately, that would be kind of cheating. especially considering the fact that I'm at least trying to show these sprites properly, even though I'm overpowered as heck. But I just need a platform, thank you. And yeah, I think I need a bit of a longer range spell. Just a sec here. Alright, we're back. I had to test out a few spells and just make sure I could actually hit her with this one. I picked Vulcan, which is actually a spell that you get at the very beginning of the game. It's the white magic and it's just a rapid fire attack. I think normally when you fight Belle... Oh, by the way, she's like, ha, you thought you won, but it's not over yet. Now it is. Ultimate weapon, my butt. Anyways, as I was saying, what was I saying? I'll at least try to remember in a bit. Anyways, alrighty. Another big V for Princess Mint. Is that like the whole Japanese thing where they make the peace sign and put it in front of their eyes and like turn their head sideways or something like that? I think that's very Japanese, actually. I think that's what she's referencing. It's when she does the peace sign for V for victory or something like that. Anyways, this windmill must do something. There's got to be some kind of secret. And if you check Belle here, she's out like a light. Oh, sweet Belle, let's see what you have. Hey, nice. Got green magic. All right. I remember what I was saying now. I think normally when you do that fight, if you hit Belle when she's on top of the hexagon, she'll actually get off and fight you like normal. Whenever she's on foot, she fights exactly like she was in the underground ruins. I'm going to have to cut this multiple times because I keep opening the magic ring, but what I need to do is select some wind magic, and hopefully I won't have to cut as much as, you know, the fact that I don't want to show the magic ring or the magic circle that lets you select all the spells. So, one sec, I'm going to select some wind magic. Alright, I picked the one that I selected the magic that I need to use here. I selected Typhoon, and you get the green magic from Belle, just seconds ago, actually. And I'm going to be using Typhoon from here on out for the rest of this place here. Please use magic. It's kind of weird. You gotta stand in a certain spot. It's not very responsive. Will you please get close to it and use it? Thank you. There we go. Okay, this room here, if you could call this place a room, it's kind of glitchy because of the fact that the game mechanic switches frequently between, you know, is this kind of more like a non-hostile scenario or is it a hostile scenario, which is why you can't just hit X anywhere in this area and you can just attack things. So yeah, that's just a weird thing. So you just gotta be staying in the right spot to use magic on the windmill. Anyways, I knew it. I wonder where it goes. Definitely smell treasure! Even though I don't remember if there's any treasure in here whatsoever. I mean, besides the earrings, of course. Speaking of which, Star Wars fans might like this place because it's like Rimja and all that, you know, those little Ewok things or whatever the heck they're called. Yeah, treetop area with lots of little short dudes with spears and tribal and all that. And you can see they're not attacking me or anything like that. But if I attack them, I just stirred the hornet's nest here. So you can actually stay here and grind and get a lot of coins or get a lot of monster coins and just, you know, get a lot of money and sell them back in town once you get home. However, I suggest coming back a second time later because you can actually come back here later. It doesn't require a rod or anything like that. You just select the place from the town gate back in Corona. But yeah, you typically don't want to attack these guys. You just want to run through the first time and basically you just want to keep going and, you know, use Typhoon once again to stir that windmill. Get on the elevator thingy and the next area. Now this place is a bit confusing in the fact that you need to hit switches a lot. And I think for this area here, my advice is to always hit the switch once whenever you come in here. I don't remember what everything you have to do to get the items, but there are some treasures you get if you hit the switches in the correct order. Oh, and those two are play fighting each other. Anyways, I did not mean to fall off and take some damage there, but let's get that thing running. You want to hold down. You want to use a lot of magic on that, even though, you know, if you need magic, you'll have to kill some of those things. The Gamulians, as they're called, and, you know, get some magic from attacking and all that. And Anyways, you just want to get across and hit that switch. If you fall in the pit, you'll be set on the right side again. So even if you don't make that jump, which it's kind of hard to make, you'll get set back towards the entrance. Anyways, take the lift back and we're back at the entrance again. Yeah, for whatever reason, that lift is connected. All lifts are connected to the entrance one. And you have to go back through the village over and over and over again. See those two levers back there? We'll actually go to that part of the forest later. But you want to have those levers facing each other. So you want to hit this one, but not this one. We'll even get to that point in the forest. In addition to that, something I should have acknowledged before I've gotten this far is the fact that, you know, Rue, if you watch, what I plan to do is upload Rue's story and Mint's story at the same time. This is the first time in the game where Rue and Mint have different storyline areas that they can go to, which means that Rue will never come to the Gamul Forest, which is here, which we need to come here with Mint, and Mint will never be able to go to Rue's area, or Rue's dungeon. No, I took the wrong path, so I think I need to have that switch to the left. One sec, I'll cut things out and meet you back here. Alright, and I'm back. Just hit the switch and go on the little trolley once again. Don't know why I can't just walk on these little train tracks and, you know, just kind of do balance beam act or something like that, but, you know, game logic and all that. It always never makes sense. Anyways, as I was saying before, there we are at these two levers. You want to have them facing each other like this. You don't want to hit the one on the right. Leave that one alone. But yeah, I was just saying, Rue has a place that he gets to go to, and he doesn't come to the Gamul Forest. It's a place called the Ghost Temple. And I plan to upload both videos at the same time, just so they go up at the same time. You know, I will alter my playlist at the same time. You know, I'm saying same time a lot. this is the first instance where Mint and Rue have different paths in their story, and shows that, you know, it's kind of the reason why the game is called Threads of Fate in America, even though, you know, Duprism is the relic that we're going after, and I don't know, maybe they thought that was going to be kind of spoilery and all that, but I don't know. But either way, this just kind of shows that this was the intention, is to have these two heroes, you know, meet up a lot in the same areas and then eventually work together to get the relic, which is the Duprism, the final goal of the game. We're in a new area here. Even though we went left twice, I remember that you need to, what are those dudes, smoking pot or something? I remember that you need to have the lever turned to the left for the most part. You want to leave that one lever on the right for later, because it'll lead to some items once we're all done. And by hitting the left lever on that platform with the two levers, you want to allow you to come to this section of the forest now. This jump is a pain. You want to turn that windmill on back first and just get it going as fast as you possibly can get it, because these will slow down after a while, and you want to see that one's slowing down and this one's slowing down too. And I cannot get that second platform. I'm sucking at platforming again, aren't I? Just missed. Yeah, they'll slow down eventually, and you will eventually need to, if you need to, you need to speed this one up. This one here actually controls the one on the right, and that one in front controls the one on the left. So, speed you up a little bit, just so we can actually get across. Wait for it. Be a bit patient this time. Okay, which one is going to slow down first? Oh, come on. How long am I going to wait for that one? There we go. After much failed platforming later, we kicked the monkey in the face. And that's all you really need to do is hit that lever. I'm going to just fall in one more time and just get out of here. After angering these guys again, if you run out of MP spinning those windmills, you can always come back here and kill these guys. And, you know, get some the little orange magic pots they drop. Plus, attacking automatically increases some of your MP just by attacking and, you know, doing damage. So I've got my MP pretty much back to maximum. Does not take long, and it's actually a good way to get some money as well, because they keep constantly respawning. So yeah, you'll get a lot of kills and be able to rack up a lot of money in a short amount of time. I don't think Rue really has anything like that, by the way, in his ghost temple. So one advantage to Mint, I suppose, besides the fact that she's got the funnier story, and quite frankly, she's got the better dialogue than Rue. I will admit that wholeheartedly, because even though Rue is more the cool dude with the shady past and the emo and all that, he might have more of the coolness factor, but Mint just takes this game. She actually makes this game a lot better than Rue does. Alright, anyways, now I remember I have to hit the switch. Now that I've hit the one after that painful platforming segment. And because I did not hit the one switch on the right in that segment with the two, I actually get this thing, the brooch. That is a key item that comes in handy later. I think you give that to Annette in the bar, and I think she gives you a free drink. I don't remember what it was. But either way, we'll find out when we get back. And all you have to do on this screen is just run to the right. And there's actually a monster in here that you can actually kill that does not actually appear until a later dungeon. So that's kind of an interesting thing to note. But anyways, dang, I'm tired. Where the heck is that guardian? Stupid guardian, you can't run from me. Come out right now. And Belle stirred the hornet's nest. She stirred the hornet's nest as well. Dang, pestilent rodents. She's almost got killed. Finally, caught up to you. That silly kick isn't gonna work this time. I just flattened you a second ago. You still want to fight? Fine, I'm not holding back. This time. And they were about ready to do a DBZ, Dragon Ball Z scene, but Mint stopped just short of that. Belle, how will we fight later? How are you getting gold feet? Take a look behind you. What? And hordes and hordes and hordes of the Gamulians. And dang, not again. Jeez, what's happening? This thing can only support one. Mint, get off! What? Why should I get off? Come on, get off, we're both going down. Then you get off. You're a lot heavier anyways. What? Take that back right now. Always insulting her weight. Ah, it's the end of the road for us, I suppose. And we hear stuff going on, but we have a black screen. Lazy animators, heave. Ack! And Belle landed on us this time. Oh, jeez, that was crazy. Where are we? You belong in hell, so we're definitely not heaven. So many good lines in this scenario. What? You could be the devil's mistress after all you've done. That bitter tongue proves you're still alive. Of course.
I'll never croak until I find the relic and conquer the world.
You heard a crunch.
Ow, my leg. Well, look at you. Jeez, it's swollen big time. You're such a klutz. It's your fault. You fell on me. Fine, I'll just end your misery. Hey, wait a minute. No! Are you crazy? You almost had a heart attack. How's the pain?
Huh? She got up and stomped her foot. I think that tells you that it wasn't actually a death spell.
Huh? Hey, what happened to the pain? Belle? Don't make me wrong. I only did it because I couldn't stand you crying. Well, I'm not going to thank you. So what now? That's easy. I'm going to find the guardian and get the earrings. And hurry up and get your butt moving.
Oh, shut up. Yeah, she expects us to do our work for her.
What are you doing? Belle, get over here. Jeez, what's with you? Behind you.
For the second time. A giant flying white whale.
But what is that disgusting thing? I think that's the guardian.
And it's gone from suck to blow. Spaceballs.
What's it doing? Mint, watch out. Oh my gosh.
At least he knows how to play his MMORPGs. Take the healer out first. And I believe this is called... It's some kind of whale. I don't remember what it's called. But this is basically how you have to fight it. It'll make these waves. You have to jump over the waves. And if you don't, you get hit and take damage. But when it'll open up its mouth, you have to use magic. I think once again I have to switch my magic. I'm not sure if I do. I'm going to try and hit him with Typhoon, but no promises. Yeah, I think I might need to switch my magic out here. You have to hit the glowing spot with magic, and otherwise he'll suck you in and blow you out. That's what she said! Switch my magic. I'm going with Vulcan once again, but I'm still going to show off more of his moves. Makes little water explosions, as you just saw, and some Gamulians will come out from above. Aside from that, the pattern is starting to repeat. And I think you know the drill by now. Don't get blown off, because you know he does create a bit of a wind gust when he flies across the screen like that. And you know, just hit him from afar with magic. And because I'm so overpowered, I kill him in one shot yet again. And I'm gonna have to do a lot of editing in this episode, because how many times I accidentally opened up the magic ring menu and I didn't intend to show it to you guys. Sorry, I know I'm being kind of anal about this, but I really don't want to show the magic ring because, you know, there's spoilery stuff, an icon that is spoilery, and then I don't want to show it till the end of the game. Anyways, hey, could this be? Yes, the earrings! And apparently we didn't have to get this thing or anything. Oh, where's Belle? And she punches her way out.
Hack, hack, hack. I've had it.
And she's out yet again.
She's unconscious.
Oh, well, there's no point in waking her up. We'd probably end up finding the earrings. I'm sure she'll be fine. All right, time to go home.
And Belle and Duke are back in their apartment, or they have a hotel room back in town. I think this is the same kind of room from Solon and Collins, I believe. Or I think that's the name of the two hotel owners. The one you have to pay 500 gold to stay in.
M'lady, I was so worried about you.
Silence. Phew, I just went through hell. E for everyone, everybody. What happened? Ugh.
M'lady, you smell funny.
Don't ever say that to a woman, guys.
I know, I was swallowed by a giant fish.
Really? What kind of fish was it? Duke, you klutz. Who cares? Damn, my body still feels gooey. E for everyone, everybody. Still couldn't get the earrings either. This really sucks. Duke, what about you? Don't tell me you failed. Sorry, m'lady, that guy you rude butted in, so I couldn't get the goods. And you actually get to see how that goes down if you play Rue's story. What? That little snot beat you? What's wrong with you? Come on, m'lady, you failed too. And she uses him as a punching bag while Solon, behind the doors, does a bit of knocking and says, excuse me, come back later, will ya? We're busy. Busy beating each other up, aren't ya? I'm sorry, but I must bring this to your attention now. It's regarding the bill. Oh no! Currently you have an outstanding balance of 2,500 gold, which, if you do the math, that's 5 nights in a row. Although I wonder if they count 2 people into that total. Maybe, maybe not. I don't know. But either way, if we were to stay there, it would be 500 gold a night. So, 5 nights. Almost a week she's been here. Really? Jeez, I completely forgot. When can we expect your payment? Sometime after tomorrow. Wait, tomorrow. We'll pay tomorrow. Is that alright? Thank you. And she's none too happy about this situation. I thought she was part of a rich family or something. I don't know. Anyways, did you hear that? We're going to have to get some money fast. If we don't find the relic and get big money, we're going to be bums. Get off your butt and fix the hexagon. Yes, my lady. Damn, I can't wait to get her. You won't be so lucky next time, Mint. E for everyone, everybody. I don't know how many times I've said that, by the way. But it's amazing how this E-rated game got away with so many swear words. Thanks for the ride. You were right. Your Pinto is one hell of a ride. E for everyone, everybody. How many times do I gotta tell you? Pulsar Inferno Typhoon Omega. Even I can't pronounce it. Stop calling it Pinto. Whatever. Okay, see you later. Yes, she doesn't even give a care. Thank Madame for me. Tell her it was a great lunch. I think we have a way to get him to do what we need to do if we ever need a favor from him from now on. Never seen him before. What a stupid hairdo.
The hell are you looking at? You want to start something, huh? What
the heck's your problem? My words exactly. I didn't even say something. Dang, you're such a punk. What a fight you're on.
What a stupid brat.
Huh? I'm not the one with the red spice on my hair. You look stupid.
Hey, I'd keep a lid of that big mouth of yours. It's gonna get you killed someday, you
bleep! You're dead! Dang, he's fast, too.
Man, I had to thump you for all that crap you said. But I got no time to play with a stupid brat like you. I'm gonna let you off for today.
Excuses, excuses. You're just a big fraidy cat.
What'd you call me?
You wanna die right now, you beep?
Take me 5 seconds to beat the crap out of you, beep, but...
Yeah, uh-huh. Alright then, show me.
Shut up. I'll grease you when I feel like it.
When's that gonna be?
It'll hit you before you notice. Today I just came by to leave you a little surprise.
Surprise?
You'll find it in that chat.
Jeez! Who the heck was that? Yeah, he will come important later, but for now, I wonder what he meant by surprise. No, he couldn't have. Elena!
Hi, Mint. Welcome home.
Hey. Did anything happen while I was gone?
No. Me with a strange hairdo came over a while ago. That's all.
Okay.
Is something wrong?
No, nothing's wrong. Freeze frame! Ugh. And she got bonked in the head with a pumpkin!
Yuck, pumpkin!
Canelo's just looking it over and is like, wow, what a big pumpkin. Did you bring this home as a gift? Are you crazy? I hate pumpkins. And we all saw that in the introduction cutscene to her story. Hey, is this the prize he was talking about? That punk, I wonder if he knows I hate pumpkins. Can't believe he set a nasty trap like this. Keyword there, folks.
I'm gonna kill him! Mint, are you alright? Dang, that's twice! Oh, he is so dead! Thanks for the gift! I'm gonna ask Mom to make her delicious pumpkin pie!
And Elena is just completely oblivious to the situation once again. Must be nice to be so carefree, and... well, maybe not so nice to be so brain dead, though, but... Welcome back, Mint. Wasn't easy, but I got the earrings. I faced a lot of opposition, but no biggie. I got the gauntlets and soul roots from the ghost temple.
Alright, we're ready to go.
I'm gonna put the gauntlets and soul roots on... Gauntlets, soul roots, and earrings on the Primadoll.
I wonder what's gonna happen.
And one thing I should mention, which I didn't mention in Rue's story, when I did his recording, is that this scene is word for word, scene for scene, animation for animation, exactly the same in both stories. Every other scene pretty much in the entire game is only slightly different. I mean, the things which are said are pretty much exactly the same, but this scene is identical in both storylines. Whoa. Hello? He's not responding.
That's it? Dang, all that effort to make this stupid doll sit up.
Just to make this stupid doll sit up. Anyways. I'm probably a doll. I'm not just a doll.
Ah! Gosh, you almost gave me a heart attack.
Wow, you can talk. Actually, I'm not talking. I'm mimicking. I analyze the sound and from your speech and produce a proper response. Responses are purely reflex and not based on any will.
You make it sound so complicated. Basically, you try to match what we say, right?
In short, yes. Hey, not bad, Mint.
What did you just say?
Excuse me, I had a slight problem with my language selection. At times, I am unable to process a proper phrase. Just chill out, alright?
That's it!
Take it easy, Mint. I'm sure you can do more than talk. Can you walk? I am not complete, but I am equipped with auxiliary motive powder. I will now initiate motion. And Kerplunk. Are you alright? I am having problems with my motor system and stability gyro.
Why don't you just say, please help me up?
And... No longer in the same cut-and-paste cutscene as before. We're back to a semi-different, but, you know, it's kind of the same overall scene for Mint's story. So he can't walk yet. I guess we need the amulet. We need that special material and make it. Did you find anything about it? Oh, yes, the Phantomite. I read through some old books while you two were gone, and lo and behold, I found out where we can get it.
Ooh, way to go, Klaus. So where can we get it?
At Raging Mountain. Wyleth lives there. He's known for collecting priceless gems and minerals. It's a good chance he has the Phantomite.
Priceless gems! I'll go! I'll get the Phantomite and then the gems really matter. I'm going to be so rich! So rich!
Well, if you assist, but Wyleth is a great dragon, over 1,000 years old. My advice is you don't challenge him.
What?
Wyleth is a dragon? A very powerful dragon. Legend says he can harness the fire and land at will.
Are you serious?
Have you heard of Dorian's tragedy? About 200 years ago, King Dorian sent his grand army to Raging Mountain. The king was after Wyleth's treasure, but his campaign failed miserably. Wyleth unleashed a seer flame that reduced the army into ashes instantly. After that, he attacked and crushed Dorian's castle and devoured the king.
That's just a fairy tale, right?
No, it's real history.
Dang.
Mint, I can't believe you're willing to go to Raging Mountain. You really are brave. Mint, be careful, okay?
Good luck!
awkward pause.
Fine, I'll go. Jeez, you guys suck.
That was the slightly different part of that scene where I think in Rue's story she's like, dang, are you crazy? I'll go get the tiara back from Belle and Duke and you go to Raging Mountain. And then Rue goes to Raging Mountain in his story. But now they kind of did that whole thing where like, good luck, Mint, have fun. Hope you don't die out there kind of thing. And it's like, fine, you guys suck. I'm going. So, yeah. Still, yet again, one of the reasons why I like Mint's story. Anyway, it's going to end up this episode real quick. Before I do, I should mention that you can fight Rod with the Golden Gale 5 more times. And each time you'll have to pay him, of course, from now on. But you can also get some money and another gold coin from him. So, yeah, you should probably do that, you know. It also helps, you know, for powering up and, you know, buy more upgrades at Hobbs' shop. But I think this episode is good and over right now. So I will end this episode off here and see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.